everybody. My name is Alice Tillman, and I'm with Steinway here in Atlanta. And I am the Steinway representative for the Bailey School of Music. Welcome to the first ever student collaborative piano recital in the history of the Bailey School of Music here at Kennesaw State University. Throughout this academic year, Sammy has been studying collaborative literature in an honors-directed study with Professor Judy Cole. I am speaking on behalf of Judy tonight. She is very sad to be missing tonight's performance, but is thrilled to be sitting with the Pitt Orchestra for the final weekend of performances of City Springs Theater Company's production of A Chorus Line. Being a collaborative pianist is a calling. It's quite different from being a solo pianist because one must have a tremendous desire to work with other artists and a temperament to do such work. This is not a path every pianist can follow, nor is it an easy one. Accompanists must have all the great technique of soloists, plus be able to support their soloists without overshadowing, and sometimes need to be able to adjust their performance when something goes awry. There's a saying that most collaboratives know and live by. I am an accompanist. I solve problems you don't even know you have in ways that you will never understand. Happily, that won't be a concern tonight. Sammy has assembled a wonderful group of students to perform with him, showcasing vocal and instrumental literature at a very advanced level. It has been my great pleasure to work with Sammy over the past several years and watch his innate abilities and talent grow through study, practice, and a great deal of dedicated work. All of us on the faculty are so proud of his development as a musician and colleague. We know you will enjoy this program. Good evening to everybody.
Thank you. don't know. Oh, it is on. So, good evening, everyone. I hope you enjoyed the opening performance of my collaborative piano recital. So, as you know, my name is Sammy Michigan. I'm a senior piano performance major here at Kennesaw State. So, I graduate in May. So, real lucky about that. Some of you may be wondering where I got the idea for this concert from. Although my degree is in piano performance, my specialty is in collaborative piano. Through the help of Judy Cole, one of the staff accompanists here and professors, as well as through overwhelming support of my fellow students, faculty, and administration of the Bailey School of Music. Over the past 3 years, I have opportunities to learn a wide variety of collaborative piano repertoire, as well as take on a significant number of performance gigs. Tonight's concert will serve in two capacities. Firstly, this is the culmination of all my collaborative piano studies at KSU so far. The second purpose is to have recordings for auditions to graduate schools and festivals in the near future. As you may notice, there's a particular order for this recital, comprising of three distinct sections, and each of them starting with an instrumental work. The first section began with a Dvorak, and this section will include three German Lieder. The second begins with the Brahms Clarinet Sonata, and includes the French Melodies and an opera aria. And the final section begins with Beethoven's Spring Sonata, and includes an English art song as well as musical theater selections. The German Lieder you're about to hear was also used for the program of my audition for the American Institute of Musical Studies, also known as the AIMS program, in Graz, Austria. If accepted, I'll have the opportunity to study collaborative piano in Austria for 6 weeks, learning from internationally recognized professors and faculty, as well as making music with amazing vocalists. I hope you enjoy these next few songs.
Thank you.
This sonata was also written for viola, though it is more often performed on clarinet. Brahms wrote two clarinet sonatas, both of them inspired by the composer Carl Maria von Weber. A fun fact about these, the keys of both sonatas that Brahms wrote correspond to the keys of the clarinet concerti that Weber composed several decades earlier. Following the Brahms will be two French melodies, Chanson Triste by Henri Duparc, which was the composer's first vocal composition. Then you'll hear Debussy's Il pleure dans mon cœur, a melody from his Forgotten Melodies. This set ends with Puccini's Quando men vo from his opera Madame Butterfly. This aria is sung by the character Musetta, in which, in front of her friends, she tries to reclaim the interest of her boyfriend Marcello. Hope y'all enjoy.
Thank you.